The White House is issuing urgent calls to action tonight in the face of COVID-19's latest assault. The appeals come amid talk of reimposing restrictions. Amna Nawaz begins our coverage.
The Biden team today issued a sober warning and an urgent call for far more vaccinations as the number of Delta-related infections is rising around the country. Dr. Rochelle Walensky is the director of the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention.
We are yet at another pivotal moment in this pandemic, with cases rising again and some hospitals reaching their capacity in some areas. We need to come together as one nation. The Delta variant is more aggressive and much more transmissible than previously circulating strains. It is one of the most infectious respiratory viruses we know of and that I have seen in my 20-year career.
As new cases of COVID surge, the Biden administration is maintaining its mask guidance.
There has been no decision to change our mask guidelines. Any decisions about public health would be driven by the CDC. But of course, we are engaged with public health experts and the CDC about how to continue to attack the virus. And we've never said that battle is over. It's still ongoing.
The seven-day average of new cases in the U.S. is up 53%. 83% of cases are now comprised of the Delta variant. And three states, Florida, Texas, and Missouri, account for 40% of all new cases nationwide. Hospitalizations and deaths are still a fraction of what they were at their peak due to vaccinations, which experts say also protect against the Delta strain. Last night, President Biden urged the public to get inoculated at a CNN town hall.
If you're vaccinated, you're not going to be hospitalized, you're not going to be in an ICU unit, and you're not going to die. So it's gigantically important that you act like we all act like Americans or care about our fellow Americans.
As U.S. officials attempt to ramp up the vaccine effort, the effort to investigate the virus's origins also continues. On Capitol Hill, some Republican lawmakers also spoke of the need for vaccines, but they focused more of their attention on China and questions that remain over how the virus first spread in 2019.
We brought in medical experts from around the country, and it was very, very eye-opening to see what they said. Every one of those medical doctors testified that the virus likely started in the Wuhan lab. Everybody in America ought to be concerned about those findings.
While some public health experts say there's not enough evidence to support the lab leak theory, the Biden administration has said the idea and evidence should be investigated further. Last week, the World Health Organization backed that too. But today, China rejected the idea entirely.
To be honest, when I first saw the WHO's second phase of an investigation into the origin of the coronavirus, I was very surprised. I feel the plan disregards common sense and defies science.
The U.S. and other governments say more information from China is needed to prevent the next pandemic, even as the work to contain this one is far from over.